Hello everyone, in the today session we will discuss about the VB.NET basics. Now let me start with what is VB.NET. VB.NET stands for Visual Basic .NET, and it is a computer programming language developed by Microsoft. It was the first released in 2002 to replace Visual Basic 6. VB.NET is an object-oriented programming language. This means that it supports the features of object-oriented programming, which include encapsulation, polymorphism, abstraction, and inheritance. Visual Basic ASP.NET run on the .NET framework, which means that it has full access to the .NET libraries. It is a very productive tool for rapid creation of a wide range of web, Windows, Office, and mobile applications that have been built on the .NET framework. So this is about VB.NET, Visual Basic .NET. Now move to the next thing. VB.NET features. These features include the following. For VB.NET is not case sensitive like other languages such as C++ and Java. It is an object oriented programming language. It treats everything as an object. Automatic code for mating, XML designer, improved object browser, etc. Garbage collection is automated. Support for Boolean conditions for the decision making. Simple multi-threading, allowing your apps to deal with multiple tasks simultaneously. Simple generic standard library. Events management, references. You should reference an external object that is to be used in a VB.NET applications. Attributes, which are tags for providing additional information regarding elements that have been defined within a program. Windows forms, you can inherit your form from an already existing form. These are the features of VB.NET. Now proceed to the next. VB.NET programming with code examples. Module, class and structure. Modules in VB.NET. A VB.NET program consists of the following modules: namespace, declaration, one or more procedures, a class or module, variables, the main procedure, comments, statements and expressions. These are the modules include in VB.NET. Now proceed to the next thing. Hello world program example in VB.NET. Step 1. Create a new console application. Step 2. Add the following code. Imports system module, module 1, prints hello guru 99, sub main function, and then console dot write line hello guru, console dot read key and sub and module. So this is the one simple example to display the hello world. First we have to import the system, then we have create a module with the module keyword, then prints hello, then sub main function, and then inside we have to print hello with the help of console dot write line, then console dot read key function, and then and sub, and last and module. Step 3, then click the start button from the toolbar to run it. It should print the following on the console. This is the output of hello. Now move to the next. Various parts of the program. See, import system, first point, module, module 1, second, likewise, I have to explain one by one. First, this is called the namespace declaration. What we are doing is that we are including a namespace with the name system into our programming structure. Second, this is called a module declaration. Here we have declared a module named module 1. VB.NET is an object oriented language, hence we must have a class module in every program. It is inside this module that you will be able to define the data and methods to be used by our program. Third, this is a comment. To mark it as a comment, we added a single quote to the beginning of the sentence statement. A VB.NET module or class can have more than one procedure. It is inside procedures where you should define your executable code. This means that the procedure will define the class behavior. A procedure can be a function, sub, get, set, add, handler, operator, remove handler, or erase event. In this line, this is where fifth point, and this is where we have specified the behavior of the primary method. The write line method belongs to the console class, and it is defined inside the system namespace. Remember, this was imported into the code. This line, point number 6, this line will prevent the screen from closing or existing soon after the program has been executed. The screen will pause and wait for the user perform an action to close it. And 7th, closing the main sub procedure. And 8th, ending the module. So these are the point explanation of the given code. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now move to the next. Class in VB.NET we use classes to define a blueprints for a data type. It does not mean that a class definition is a data definition, but it describes what an object of that class. An object is an instance of a class. The class members are the methods and variables defined within the class. To define a class, we use the class keyword, which should be followed by the name of the class. The class body and the end class statements. This is described in the following syntax. See that class name, class keyword, name, then inherit the class name, statements, and then end class. This is the syntax. I'll explain these things with one simple example. So now proceed to the next thing. VB.NET class example. Step 1, create a new console application. Step 2, add the following console following code. Import system module 1 class figure name of the class, then public length as a double, then public breadth as a double, and class sub main function dim we can use to declare a variable, rectangle as a figure equal to new figure, dim area as a double equal to 0.0, rectangle dot length equal to 8.0, rectangle dot breadth equal to 7.0, area equal to rectangle dot length multiply by rectangle dot breadth. Then we have to print using console dot write line area of rectangle is in curly braces 0 comma area, console dot read key and sub, and then add module. So this is one class example in VB.NET, and here we have to calculate the area of a rectangle. I hope it is clear. It's a very simple example to calculate the area of the rectangle, and we have defined this concept using the class in VB.NET. Now move to the next thing. Step 3, run this code by clicking the start button from the toolbar. You should get the following window. Area of rectangle is 56. Now proceed to the next. Explanation of the code. So just we have discussed about how to calculate the area of the rectangle using the class in VB.NET. So see the code explanation from line 1. So 1, first point, creating a module name module 1, then creating a class named figure, creating a class member named length of type double, it is access level has been set to public, meaning that it will be accessed publicly. Fourth point, creating a class member named breadth of type double, at access level has been set to the public, same meaning, that is be accessed publicly. Fifth point, adding the class. Next point, creating the main sub procedure. Then next, creating an object named rectangle. this object will be of type figure, meaning that it will be capable of accessing all the members defined inside the figure class, defining a variable named area of type double and initializing its value to 0.0, accessing the length property defined in the figure class and initializing its values to 8.0. Next, accessing the breadth property defined in the figure class and initializing the value to 7.0. The next, calculating the area of the rectangle by multiplying the values of length and breadth. The result of this calculation will be assigned to the area variable. The next, printing some text and the area of the rectangle on the console. And then next, posting the console, waiting for a user to take action to close it. And next, ending the sub procedure, and last, ending the class. So this is the explanation of these code line by line. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now move to the next thing. How to create a console application project in Visual Studio. Step 1, open the Visual Studio and click the file menu, choose new, then project from the toolbar. See that file, then new, and then project. And continuation. Step 2, on the new window, click Visual Basic. From the left, vertical navigation pane, choose console application. See that in the left hand pane, you can choose the Visual Basic. Then in right side pane, you can choose the console application, and then you can mention the name and the location, and then you will click on OK. Now VB.NET data type and the variable declaration with the dim keyword. What are the data types? Data types determine the type of data that any variable can store. variables belongings to different data types are allocated different amounts of space in the memory. There are various data types in VB.NET. They include like Boolean. The allocated storage depends on the platform of implementation. Its value can be either true or false. Byte allocated storage space of 1 byte. Values range from 0 to 255. Unsigned. The next char allocated a space of 2 byte. Values range from 0 to 65535. Unsigned. Next, date allocated storage space of 8 bytes. Values range from 0:00:00. Midnight, for example, January 1, 0001 to like this 11:59:59 PM of December 31, like that. Integer has a storage space of 4 byte and the values range between these. Next, long data types has a storage space of 8 byte. Numbers range from this. Next, string. The storage space allocated depends on the platform of implementation. Values range from 0 to about 2 billion Unicode characters. So these are data types. And the data types is basically what type of value you can store in a respective variables. Now move to the next thing. In the continuation, data type and the variable declaration. The next thing is the type conversion functions. They are function that we can use to convert from one data type to another. They includes like cbool expression, convert the expressions to Boolean data type. Cdate, convert the expressions to date data type. Likewise, cdbl, cbyte, cchar, clang, cdec, cint, cob object, cstr string, csbyte, cshort. So these are the functions we can use to convert in the respective data types. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now move to the next. VB.NET data type and variables declaration within variable declaration. Here is an example of valid variable declaration in VB.NET. See, them acts as an integer. Variable initialization. Initializing a variable means assigning a value to the variable. The following example demonstrates this. Then x as integer and x equal to 10. Above we have declared an integer variable named x and assigned it a value of 10. Here is another example. Then name as a string, name equal to John. So like this you have to declare an a variable and you can initialize with the numerical value or the textual value. Ruby.NET data types and the variable. Declaration with them. Let us demonstrate how to declare and initialize a variable using a code example. Step 1. Create a new project. Open Visual Studio and click the file menu, choose new, then project from the toolbar. See file, then project. Now the next step, on the new window click Visual Basic from the left vertical navigation pane. Choose window from forms application. See here Visual Basic, and in the right hand side you can choose the window form application. Then you have to write down the name of that project. And then you can click on OK. Now step 2, create a button control. See here in the toolbox the button tool is there. Simply we have to drag and drop, or we can double click on that tool, then it will insert this control button. And how you can perform this action, so that we can write or we can add the code, add the following code to add text to the control. Private sub button 1 underscore click event, sender as a object, e as an event args, handle button dot click. This method will automatically open and you have to write dim checker as a boolean and checker equal to true. Message box, the value of the variable checker is ampersand checker, dim x as an integer x equal to 32, and the message box the value of variable x is colon ampersand x, dim name as a string, name equal to guru, message box the value of the variable name is ampersand name and sub. to the next thing. Here is a screenshot of the complete code we have just discussed. Now I have to explain line by line. Explanation of the code. First point, creating a public class named form1 and creating a sub procedure named button 1_click. It will be called when the button is clicked. The sender object will raise the event, while a argument will have data for the event. Next, creating a boolean variable named checker, assigning a values of true to the checker variable. Next, creating a message box dialog to show some text and the values of variable checker, creating an integer variable named x, assigning a value of 32 to the variable x. Then next, creating a message box dialog to show some text and the values of variable x, creating a string variable named name, assigning a variable of guru to the variable name, creating a message box dialog to show some text and the value of variable name. Ending of the sub procedure. Next, ending the class. So this is about the code explanation line by line, and I hope it is clear to everyone of each and every line. So thank you for the today's session, and I hope you have to understood about the basic of the .NET.